You may not have noticed, but Google have brought us some really useful features to make life easy. You can actually use Google to book a ride, identify almost any song, and even split the bill with your friends. By the way, this video is sponsored by Audible. Listen to your favorite audiobooks on the go. Otherwise, guys, let's get into it. So first up in those really useful features is if you head on over to Google Lens and you simply lift up a receipt from your lunch date or dinner date, Google Lens will identify all that information, and if you click on that gray dot, this little calculator will pop up, and here you can actually put in what you would like to tip your waiter. So for example, I just said 25%, and then I want to split the bill between three people. Then once I've put in those metrics, as you can see, Google Lens automatically calculates the tip and total that each individual has to pay. And then another thing you can do is go back and change the amount. So say, for example, you actually want the tip to be 30% and there's now five of you that you need to split the bill with. Of course, just pop that information in and automatically Google Lens will calculate everything for you. So useful. Now, this is another really useful Google Lens feature. And once again, if you access Google Lens and you select that dining icon, and then you just place a menu in front of Google Lens. So here, for example, I have a Starbucks menu. You take a picture, and then right at the top there, you see select a restaurant. Simply type the name of the restaurant in. So I said Starbucks. This just helps Google Lens know exactly what restaurant menu you're busy looking at. And then once you select the restaurant, Google identifies every menu item. And then anything with an orange highlight like this is actually one of their top selling items. So in this case, it's their signature hot chocolate. But then on top of that, if you click on any other menu item, Google will show you images of that. So this is quite nice, especially when you come across some food items that you're not quite sure what they are. Just use Google Lens. Ooh, now this one is seriously nifty. Let's just say you're getting directions somewhere. You start off those directions. What you'll now see in Google Maps is this little icon. And if you click on that, you can actually now report a number of different things that you may potentially see on the road. So for example, here I am reporting a speed camera or an object in the road. It'll take a couple of seconds to load, and then just like that, it has been added to Maps so that everyone else now using Google Maps will actually see little notifications. You can only report one thing at a time. You reach a report limit, which kind of makes sense. But then when you're actually traveling on the road and you see these little icons, you simply tap it, it'll show it's a speed camera, and then you just slow down. These days in a busy world, it's not always easy being on time. But with Google Maps, they just make life a little bit easier. So if you're busy navigating somewhere and you click on that little up arrow icon, then over here you will see share trip progress. And what you can do with this is share your trip progress with a contact. So I'm just selecting Mike here. I click the share button. And then as you can see, I get a little notification that my location has been shared, but then Mike will also get a notification. And if he clicks on that, it'll actually show him the entire progress of my trip. What's even more interesting is he'll even be able to see my phone's battery percentage, exactly what time I'm going to arrive at my destination, and the exact route I'm going to take to get there. So this is a really nifty feature for friends and family, and if at any time you want to stop sharing your location, you just hit that stop sharing icon and you're good. If you happen to come across a banging track and you want to know the name of that song so you can listen to it later, then all you have to do is say, "Hey Google, what song is this?" Just like that, Google will listen in and boom, actually identify the song that's playing. But on top of that, if you have Spotify, Google will actually provide a nice little link, and if you tap on that, it'll open up the song in Spotify, and then from there, you can save it to your favorite playlists and enjoy. Pretty nifty. Did you know that if you say, "Hey Google, get me a ride to Santon City," Google will take a few minutes to think and then respond,
"All right, taxi to Santon."
And then just like that, provide you with a bunch of information on various different rides you can choose to get to Santon, or of course, your destination of choice. But what's really nice about this is Google cross-compares rates for you, so you don't have to go through all these various apps and try and find the best rate. It's all there, easy peasy, lemon squeezy, and then if you find the rate you want, simply open up the app, and then from there, you can get a little bit more information and of course, book your ride. And then what's also cool is if you don't want to use the Google Assistant route, you can just go onto Google Chrome, type in the same thing, and once again, Google does all the cross-comparing for you and provides you with a list of different rates, fares, and applications you can use to get to your destination. I don't know about you guys, but sometimes I put my phone down somewhere, I completely forget where it is, and then I'm like, oh my gosh, where's my phone? Have I lost it? I start panicking, but with Google Assistant and with the Google Home Mini, all you do is say, hey Google, find my phone.
Should I ring it?
Yes.
All right, your phone should be ringing now.
And just like that, Google, of course, rings your phone, so it's way easier to find it. And this is a seriously nifty tool that makes life so much easier and less stressful. Another really helpful feature is if you head on over to Google and you type in how to pronounce and then your word. So I just said smartphone. Then of course you just click the search button and right over here, front and center, you'll see this little playhead. And then if you click on it, it'll actually show you how to pronounce the word. You can also slow down the pronunciation so it's easier to perhaps understand and watch how the mouth movements are slower. And what you can also do is change it from British pronunciation to American pronunciation. So this is a really nifty tool for a number of different reasons. And here's just a quick example. So you guys can see the difference in the pronunciation.
Popcorn. Popcorn.
So this is really cool, and there are so many different words to try this with.
Epiglottis.
Epiglottis.
Did you know you can ask Google to remember a whole bunch of things? Like, remember I put the keys on the kitchen counter? Or remember I took my vitamins this morning? And then at any time throughout the day, you can ask Google to remind you what you asked it to remember. Which actually reminds me. Hey Google, what did I ask you to remember?
Here's what you told me. Remember to tell me to tell your audience how amazing Audible is and the free Audible trial.
Oh yes! Amazing! And speaking of amazing, the best app by far for listening to audiobooks has got to be Audible. Guys, they seriously have an unmatched selection of audiobooks, original audio shows, news, comedy, and so much more. Personally, I actually love listening to business books, and I'm currently listening to The Road Less Stupid, and I'd highly recommend this book, guys, if you love learning about business. With the Audible app, you can listen on the go while shopping, cooking, going to the gym, traveling, basically anytime, anywhere, on any device. Go to audible.com/Hales World or text Hales World to 500-500 and you can get 3 months of Audible for just $6.95 a month. You can choose one audiobook and two Audible originals absolutely free, and that's more than half of the regular price, guys, and this is for a limited time only. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like and subscribe, or you can check out some of my other videos right over here, but I will see you in the next one. Toodles!